1530, the Reformation is in full swing. Luther published the German translation of the New Testament in 1522. He had returned from the Wartburg Castle to Wittenberg, where he started the Reformation, by nailing his 95 theses to the door of All Saints Church back in 1517. Luther's friend Lucas Cranach the Elder was appointed court painter of Saxony and lives in Wittenberg, too. One morning as Luther came by for a chat at Cranach's workshop, Emilia, one of the Saxon princesses, stops by.
Hello, Master Cranach, you look dapper today.
I'm portraying myself with the Holy Family, I better look the part.
I wouldn't call this a holy outfit. Oh. Martin Luther is here too. What's new in the world of theology, Brother Martin?
Aus einem verzagten Arsch kommt kein fröhlicher Furz.
Princess Emilia, I'm sure you didn't come to listen to Luther's adolescent jokes.
Oh, that's quite all right. Remember, I just became a teenager last month. But let's talk business. I have decided it's time to get a husband and I will need a few paintings for my profile.
Die Weiber sind hauptsächlich dazu bestimmt, die Geilheit der Männer zu befriedigen.
Princess Emilia, what did you have in mind?
I want to send different messages. First, I want to be seen as a fashion icon.
We have specialists for silk dresses, fur coats and feather hats. You can work with them to put together the outfit you like. We can also add some precious stones and other accessories.
Sounds swell. Then I definitely need a nude. But I don't want to do Venus or Eve. They are way too overused. Got any ideas?
Frauen haben nämlich einen breiten Arsch und weite Hüften.
How about something along the lines of justice?
Yes, I like this justice thing. This gets me right to my next point. I won't be pushed around by my husband. So let's send a subtle message with the theme of Judith with the head of Holofernes.
Will die Frau nicht, so kommt die Matt.
While Cranach and his team were working on the paintings, dramatic events developed in the boudoir of Princess Emilia.
Oh Mary, I can't get married. Why? I'm becoming a man myself. What do you mean? I grow hair in my armpits, on my legs and all over my lady parts.
Silly you. Don't you worry, we will clean you up good. Let me get my book of secrets and I will prepare the lotion. I will need 1 pint of arsenic and 1/8 pint of quicklime. Put it on in the bathhouse. And when the skin feels hot, wash it off quickly with hot water so the flesh doesn't come off.
The paintings were swiftly delivered and not long thereafter Emilia had her first dates. Some documents have survived in the archives.
They say I'm too young to love you. I don't know what I need. They think I don't understand.
Ein williges Pferd soll man nicht zu viel reiten.
I think I'm too cool to know ya. You say I'm like the ice I freeze.
Nur, wer sich entscheidet, existiert.
But then came a message.
Hello, Princess Emilia. I'm Count George, the Pious.
And the princess started to dream.
In der Woche zwier, schaden weder ihm noch ihr, macht im Jahre 104.
And then Count George came in person.
Will you marry me?
And so Emilia got married to the more than 30 years old George, Count of Ansbach on August 26, 1533. They had 4 children including the heir George Friedrich. Husband George died in 1543 while Emilia lived for almost another half century. She died in 1591, aged 74, in Ansbach.